Do you still feel the chills? I'll tell you what, a lot of people do. Welcome to the Les Miles Show. I'm Dave Hunziker. My pleasure to welcome alongside the head coach at Oklahoma State, Les Miles. And what a way to end the year. A win on the road at Oklahoma, Coach.
There was some excitement down in Norman last Saturday, and we went down there to win. And kids played hard, believed in themselves, and they came away with victory.
The reception across the state from Oklahoma State fans, even nationwide, has been terrific. So many people have enjoyed this win. What a great day for the Cowboys.
I've been on the road since Sunday in a number of schools and homes, and people have gone out of their way to send congratulations back to the school and to the players. A lot of people saw us play on Saturday, and we're rooting for the Cowboys.
And you're going to get a chance to see many of the highlights from the game. Lots of highlights of the Cowboys and Sooners when the Les Miles Show continues after this.
The Les Miles.
Welcome back. Let's waste no time. Highlights, the Cowboys and Oklahoma. The season finale from Owen Field in Norman. Big-time atmosphere, as you would expect, for Bedlam 2001. Lots of Cowboy fans in attendance, and your team taking the field and an upset in the making, Coach.
It was a great day. Temperature was just right. There was some intensity on the field. You could tell our guys were coming to play. Opening kickoff, we received the opening kickoff, and we come back. Did not get what we're used to in our return coverage, but we knew it was going to be a hard hit, hitting game, and it started right from the start.
The thing is, the wind was a big factor in the first half, and in the first quarter, you had to go into what was really about a 30 to 35 mile per hour wind.
And we had the wind then in the second quarter, and then eventually we had the wind in the fourth quarter. So we enjoyed the opportunity at the wind. Rashaun starts the day out with a nice reception on the sideline, and there was some contact and some licks being delivered. Our quarterback gets hit right there, and really not his fault on the interception, but they picked it off, and we knew that it was going to be that kind of day. Our defense then starts out to show them what kind of day it was going to be. Our defense was dominant start to finish, and if you watch these highlights, you'll see different names and different men making plays.
All right, Coach, with that thought in mind, you held Oklahoma to just 220 yards of total offense and had seven sacks. In basic terms, what was the gist of the game plan? What were you trying to do, and what made it so successful?
Well, we wanted to, as you can see right here, we're pressuring the quarterback, and we wanted to pressure the quarterback and then give him a zone drop that he might not necessarily be comfortable with and confuse, and obviously the defense was successful. But you know, no plan is going to win this game for you. It's going to be effort and fight and contact and fundamental football, and our guys took it to our opponents this week.
Here we see the field position becoming a story again. The holding penalty backs you up, and really throughout that first quarter, as Bell squirts through here for his biggest game of the day, 19 yards, field position was a big factor that your defense helped you overcome in that first quarter.
Bell played hard, really matured through the season, and we're looking forward to a good future from him at the tailback spot. Also, little Aaron on a throw, and we're getting a slow start. Scott Elder has just been tremendous for us all season, and in this game, kicking into the wind in the first quarter, just boots the ball. And if you watch how a senior responds to a big game, you just look at Elder, because he was a great player for us all afternoon. This defense now is flying around. If they rush the passer, they turn around, retrace their steps, and make a tackle on the screen. A little swing pass on the sideline, and again, short of the first down.
Third and two situation coming up here, and attacking the football as your defense did throughout the course of the day, and another big play.
Derrick Williams, a true freshman, played well in this game as well as he has all season, and we look forward to his development in the future.
Punt rolls out of bounds, and the Cowboys get what really turned out to be your best field position of the first quarter, starting up on offense again.
Tatum had a couple of good cuts and nice runs in this game, and we hand the ball to Denard, he gets a significant yardage, and it's 3rd and 13. They have to step back and throw it, and it goes right through the hands of Rashaun, and they pick it off. And so in really very early in the game, we turn the ball over twice, and our defense must respond to keep us in this game, and they do so.
Oklahoma trying to get on the board first here in the first quarter. The field was tilted their way throughout much of the first quarter, but boy, the Cowboy defense was just terrific. Another big play on defense here is another one of those sacks, and that one coming from Marcus Jones, who had just a wonderful game.
Marcus Jones was named Defensive Player of the Big 12 Conference, a senior graduating, playing in his last ball game in Cowboy uniform, and played his best ball game.
Coach, as the first quarter unfolded and your team survived not only the wind, but the field position situation, I'm sure you and your squad gained a lot of confidence and momentum from that.
We did, and now Josh Fields comes in and takes his first snap on the 5-yard line, and their defense is playing hard. This is going to be a good football game. We know it's going to be competitive, and sure enough, we're trying to get off of our goal line, and we're just not having that opportunity. Deep in his end zone, Elder comes back and just knocks another good punt out of there. We are very fortunate to have had the best punter in the contest that Saturday.
Keep in mind, Cowboys in this first quarter were going into about a 30 to 35 mile per hour wind, and your defense takes over from there.
And if you watch, you're looking at a number of people with opportunities to make the play. Llewellyn Brown, Kevin Williams, Kareem Smith. I mean, it's a gathering at the ball for the Oklahoma State defense.
In fact, Oklahoma on offense had 0 yards rushing for the game, and here's another big play by Jones, the interception to thwart the Sooners again.
Marcus takes a deflection and jump balls the deflection and turns it into our possession.
Boy, how things change. Your defense really struggled to generate turnovers early in the season, but so many big plays in these last two games, Les.
Well, and that's the style of defense that we're developing at Oklahoma State. But I enjoyed most recently the success that Rashaun Woods is having. This is his the reception that breaks Hart Lee Dykes' single season career mark. And he's had a great year, and we expect great things from Rashaun in the future.
Little quarterback draw here with Fields, but back to Woods. What makes him so good?
He's a hard worker. He comes to practice every day to get better. And he gets on the in the game. He expects to make the play. And when you have that kind of attitude, you can make some big plays, and he has all year.
Move into the second quarter of a scoreless game, and Hybl, who had just a tough afternoon, even finding a target to throw to, is chased down again.
Our defensive line in front seven really put pressure on Hybl all day, and you can see it here with Llewellyn Brown getting one of his sacks.
7 sacks, as I mentioned earlier, posted by the Cowboys during the course of this game, and Oklahoma finding the going very tough. And how about this play by Paul Jones?
Paul Jones comes really out of nowhere, makes an interception that just looks like he snatched it out of the air. Great hands. The Orange Pride stirs in attendance, so there's a lot of orange in that stadium. And a lot of excitement provided to them by the Oklahoma State football team.
Unfortunately, the ball goes right back to Oklahoma as another ball went through a receiver's hands.
The throws were pretty good. We just need to bring that ball into us and not let it pass through our hands.
We moved into action later in the second quarter, as you can see. Hybl trying to scramble and make a play, and a very unfortunate face mask penalty gives them an opportunity to take it to the end zone.
Surely not a significant face mask. He didn't grab the face mask cleanly, got a piece of it, turned his head around. It was a good call by the official.
And from there, the Sooners hit pay dirt and take a 7-0 lead. Boy, that was really a disappointing and frustrating turn of events there in a football game, because your defense had played so well, but there Oklahoma with great field position, able to cash it in. But your offense comes right back to gain some momentum.
John Lewis has been a great contributor all season long, and he's makes a great catch here, and sure-handed, and turns in a run after catch as well.
it was significant to come right back on offense after that touchdown, wasn't it?
You have to answer, and we have another throw to John here on the sideline, and he takes contact, but it's first down and a great reception. A little naked off the corner, and then we threw a comeback on the sideline to Rashaun Woods, third and six in their territory. Big play, throws to Milosevic, and Milosevic picks up the first down.
Here comes another big play. The leading receptions man for a single season in OSU history, Rashaun Woods.
And on this play as well, there was pressure, and the protection that was afforded the quarterback was key to the play. If you look, he bumps, he throws the ball to the outside. Rashaun makes a great play. It's the perfect example of your hands coming away from your body to make the catch and concentrating on the ball, not necessarily the goal line, because had he concentrated on the goal line, he may not have made the catch.
Unfortunately, the illegal procedure follows.
First and 2 inches, and we jump, and we're backed up and end up in a position where we're going to have to kick the field goal, which was really unfortunate because we'd like to have had those 4 points down the road.
Obviously, the penalty just changed everything offensively there in the goal line situation, didn't it?
No question. Nice throw there. Had an opportunity at a touchdown there. We throw a comeback screen to the tight end, miss a block, and we're going to have to kick it.
And Luke Phillips, who's had a terrific year, knocks it in from 26 yards out.
Luke's been a real joy to work with, a real competitor, hardworking, just everything you ever wanted in an extra point placement guy.
One of the few big plays of the day here for Oklahoma, Coach.
They throw the ball across the middle, and Paul Jones makes the play, and he is also a graduating senior that had a real significant contribution in this game. Terrence Robinson, again, a physical play, and third and one, and Chris Massey and the crew tackling, they call face mask. Again, I believe it was a good call, and again, it was not a flagrant violation. Marcus Jones makes a big play that would have surely been a touchdown if he doesn't get his hands on that ball. He's injured. They take him out for a series, but nothing was going to keep him out of this game. Third down and three. They throw it inside. These are all points that they could have scored 7 points, and this defense steps up, and they're kicking a three-pointer, which really, as you look down the road, it became very important.
And Oklahoma chose not to kick it off deep to your outstanding kickoff returner, Chris Massey, and you took advantage of the field position and took it down the field with less than a minute to work with.
Special teams helped us all year long, and that's another example. Tatum Bell makes a great run to start the series, back to Milosevic for the first down. As they move the chains, the clock stops. They're blitzing pretty regularly and pressuring us. We're down, it's a 52-yarder, and it just comes inside, nicks the upright. And that 3 points really led to momentum going into the second half. Elder puts the ball on the ground in a difficult hold. And again, it just goes inside. Luke used a little body language to nudge that ball inside the goalpost, but it's good. It's 10-6 at halftime, and we have some momentum going off the field.
The longest field goal of the year for Luke Phillips. In fact, he told me after the game, the longest field goal he's ever made in any game. And your team obviously had, with that field goal and the play of your defense in the first half, a lot of momentum going into the locker room. What'd you tell him at the half?
Well, we knew that this would be the position that we wanted to be in. We were in striking distance for victory. The thing that had to happen is we had to continue to put pressure on their passer. We had to continue to pressure their defense, and that's really what happened from that point forward.
Coming up, the drama unfolds in the second half. Second half highlights of the Cowboys and the Sooners coming up. Welcome back. Onward to the second half we go of Bedlam 2001. The Cowboys and the Sooners from Owen Field in Norman. At the half, the Cowboys trailed in the football game by a score of 10-6. Had the ball to start the second half, Coach.
Tatum Bell, again, is running hard and with confidence. Exactly what we needed out of his contribution for that day. put formation in the boundary, and the quarterback pulls the ball down and gets necessary yards on a scramble. Third and seven, steps back in the pocket, makes a nice read. Even though it's incomplete, we really felt like he may have been interfered with.
Scott Elder comes into the game and launches another fine punt. But nonetheless, Oklahoma with good field position as you are going into the wind in the third quarter.
And again, our defense is going to have to rise to the occasion at this point. And if you watch this series of hits from this point throughout the remainder of the game, you'll see great contact delivering blows. And this is our senior captain, Dwayne Levels, doing exactly what he's done for us all season long. Twist up front, nice throw across the middle, and again, Chris Massey with great contact in their stadium.
Even in watching this videotape, you can see in the body language of the players their confidence growing as this game moves along, even though Oklahoma had a big gainer there.
Our defense was playing so well, and it was obvious from the sidelines that this Oklahoma team was not going to score significant points, and if our offense would come to bear late in the game, that we would win.
A huge sack there from Kevin Williams.
They had seven sacks on the day, mm-hmm. and everybody contributed. It was truly a great effort by the defense. They interfere. They stepped inside the halo within 2 yards of the catch, and our receiver really could not receive that ball. So
we advanced to later in the third quarter. Oklahoma with the football back, and there a shovel pass is snuffed out by the defense as the defense continues to play terrific football.
Darren Williams, a true freshman, is going to play a lot of football for us, and he was very aggressive in that game and made some real physical tackles.
Nearly a blocked punt there. The Cowboys came close on a couple of occasions to blocking a punt, but the result is a fairly short kick. However, roughing the punter against the Cowboys gives Oklahoma another chance, but the defense says, hey, so what?
Really felt like that was a difficult call to make in a game such as that, but it didn't make any difference. The defense was going to play over that adversity. It's a great job by Clay Coe coming in there and making a sack. Oklahoma City young man, and obviously very excited about that contribution.
You know, you made the comment earlier, just so many names to call, and we've called so many different names during the course of this game. Just a terrific defensive display. That's a touchdown, but no, it's not. You can't push somebody in the back and catch it. It's pass interference against Oklahoma.
He put his hands on Paul Jones's back and really drug him down before he received the ball. So it was a good call by the official. And again, contact. That ball's coming out. They go to punt from their side of the field. And we really had good field position until this punt. And that was really an uncalled for contact. But the officials was right on the play and made the proper call.
That's a 15-yard penalty that helps the cause and helps your offense from being inside the 10 to being out beyond the 20.
They hand the ball to Michael Denard for a short gainer, third and 10. Back in the pocket, he decides to pull it down, and this is really a great play in the scheme of things. He runs for the first down, something that we need from our quarterback. It also happened to be the time where he dislocated his thumb. He comes to the sideline. It's a pretty vivid picture, recognizing that thumb was out of whack, and the doctor prescribed a straightening, and it was a very audible straightening. You could really hear that thumb being put back in joint. And I was concerned that he might not return the contest, but very much like Josh Field, he would return with a smile on his face and took snaps, and he was ready to go back in and finish the contest.
Third quarter comes to an end. You trail 10-6. You talked about Josh Fields. Boy, he does a lot of things that are very unfreshman-like, doesn't he?
You know what, he's a competitor from a real competitive family, father and mother, both of strong sports backgrounds, and nothing would surprise me with him. He steps on the field in competition, he's pretty much at home.
Oklahoma on the move again, trying to extend the lead to two scores. But your defense comes up with some huge plays here, Coach.
If you watch this play, that last play was made by three. This play here was pressure, and they didn't really, they weren't in sync in the throw. It's third and goal. They throw it across the middle, and Elbert Craig, again, in contact, separates the ball from the receiver.
We'll get another look at this hit, and Craig, who's been your leading tackler throughout the course of the year, makes a great play here to keep the Sooners out of the end zone.
You know, this is a football. This football is a contact sport, and you can see that Oklahoma State is using that part of the game to help progress in the victory.
So you're midway through the fourth. You're down by a touchdown. What was your thought process? What were you thinking at this point?
Well, we had to move the football and get in there tighter, and obviously the quicker throws were the better. John Lewis catches a slant here for a nice gain. And we knew that we were going to move the football in the air, and we wanted to mix it up with the run. But at this point, we needed to get some points.
And that big play to Lewis energizes the Cowboys on this drive midway through the fourth quarter.
Again, Rashaun Woods with another quick slant to the outside. And we throw our little screen that we've been running all year long, and caught him in a defense that allowed us to pick up another first down. Again, they're pressuring us, linebackers running by us, and Rashaun almost makes this play as the ball just went over his outstretched arms.
The illegal procedure against the Cowboys moves it back 5 yards, and that results in a long field goal attempt by Luke Phillips. And boy, this turned out to be a very important play in this football game, as Phillips called upon again to hit from 52 yards.
Luke, 52 and 53 in opportunities to kick. He's perfect, and the score's 13-9, and we're 4 points down with an opportunity to win this football game.
Defense comes back on the field and basically does what it's done all day long. And here comes Marcus Jones saying hello to Nate Hybl.
Marcus played awfully well, and he makes identical sack earlier in the game, and he's coming in with some contact for the OU quarterback as well.
All kinds of different things on defense that you threw at the Sooners, didn't you?
There were some change-ups. I thought the defensive staff did a great job with game plan. The kids believed in what they were going to do, and they played lights out, which is ultimately what you need to have happen in big games.
All right, here we are. A little more than 3 minutes left, and we advance forward in this touchdown drive that would win the football game, and it's about making plays now, isn't it?
Well, and we go to the young man that's made the most plays for us offensively, Rashaun Woods, on the sideline. He gets down, first down, and we're moving the ball. Throw a little screen for a short gain to Tatum.
And the play of the day is coming up, Coach. Would you agree?
Well, I don't think there's any question. T.D. Bryant makes the play that enables us to score. The ball was laid up in the center of the field. Their great strong safety had the opportunity. T.D. came across to make that catch. And now we're right down in there with the opportunity to score. And you can see the replay. He's the Williams is in position to make the catch, and TD comes in front of him and snatches it away from him.
What a big time catch.
You count on that with TD Bryant in the game. He's going to make those plays.
First and goal, time for the game winner, and appropriately enough, it comes from Rashaun Woods.
Mr. Clutch, I don't think there was any question on their minds or ours where we were going to go with the ball. This receiver should well be the All Big 12 wide receiver, and he was named second team, which I'm sure there are other qualified candidates, but wearing orange every week like we do, he's the best wide receiver in this conference.
Was not an easy catch, Coach.
Well, he got both feet down. He does a great job of positioning the defender, and then uses his hands, and both feet come down.
Can you possibly convey your emotions at that time?
just for a few seconds, you let yourself go. And,
of course you do.
And enjoy it. And but let's get this extra point because that makes the lead three. And
that wraps up a perfect year, by the way, in point after attempts for Luke Phillips, just part of what was a terrific season for him. And time for the defense to get it done a couple more times.
Tipped ball on the first attempt out of his own end zone, rolls, again, pressured, incomplete, third and 10, was pressured out of the grasp, throws it out of bounds. Right now we're figuring out the time on the clock and what we need to do beyond this fourth and 10. If it's incomplete in his own end zone, ball's tipped, dag near intercepted again. And yeah, it's gonna be our ball. And what we elected to do was to sit on it, run the clock down. Didn't feel like they would have the opportunity to score. And so we're trying to use the clock up as quickly as we can.
But Oklahoma does get one last chance, but it turns out to be nothing significant as the defense again steps up and closes the deal.
Well, there's a number of white jerseys back there, and one of ours, Marcus Jones, comes down with the their last offensive play. We sit on it, and they decide to get me wet with some Gatorade. There's some happiness in Norman right there for those folks wearing orange. Coach Stoops was very gracious and humble, and we enjoy the association and the competition with that team.
What a great win. I mean, it just bears repeating. What a terrific win and a total team effort by your football team to get it done in Norman.
The this football team has character. This football team thought all along from the beginning of the year that they could be a really good football team. And we had opportunities to prove it, probably none more significant than that Saturday in Norman.
Coming up, there were so many players who played a key role in the Cowboy victory, but Tom Dorado had a chance to sit down with three of them who will also be back on the squad next year, perhaps to create more magic. We'll hear from Tom after this.
It's time to save big at your Oklahoma Ford dealer. Get 0.0% financing or up to $1,500 cash back on Ford Super Crew, the only truck in its class to...
Welcome back. There were just so many individuals who made play after play in Norman, plays that would help make it a week to remember. Tom Dorado visited with three Cowboys who made a difference last weekend and will again when we tee it up in 2002.
Rashaun, you've had a few days now to reflect on the past season, also on that great afternoon down in Norman. What are your thoughts?
That this team has been improving every week, and I think the game against OU, we really put it together on offense and defense. Everybody, you know, some weeks we'd improve more on offense than some on defense, you know, vice versa. But I think OU, it all came together and we really, you know, got the job done. We were sold on Coach Miles and the coaches and what they were doing each week, and it paid off.
We talked right after the game, and you made the remark that this is a moment that you'll remember the rest of your life. Take us, if you will, inside the huddle on that touchdown drive. You know, what was going on? What was being said?
That we were going to win. You know, I think as soon as we got in the huddle for first play, I heard John Lewis say, "Hey, we're about to win this. We're about to win this." And I guess from then on, we didn't get in the huddle. But once after that, didn't nobody say anything. Everybody was focused on what they had to do, and we were kind of in hurry-up mode. And we got out there, got lined up correctly, and went down the field and scored.
I would think after the pitch to Bryant, you guys really believed then.
I mean, it was unbelievable. I mean, my heart just started racing after that beautiful catch. I knew that they were coming to me, and my heart was, I mean, racing. I got nervous. You know, I haven't been nervous like that in a long time. He came up, he was ready, and I was ready. And we got this, you know, went after it, and I came down with the ball.
For those of you coming back next year, that game in Norman had to be kind of a boost of great confidence, to say the least. It'll help you during the off season.
Oh, definitely. We will not fear anybody from now on. I think some games there was a fear factor there in some games, but now we've played against the best and beat the best, and we should be proud of ourselves, and we shouldn't lay down anybody.
By by your example alone, you're going to be thrust into a leader's role next year. Can you be a little bit more vocal as well?
Yeah, I think I can. Just do whatever helps the team. And we're going to have a lot of senior leadership next year. You know, those juniors, they led this year. And so, I will try to lead in the best way that I can. You know, probably not as vocal because we have so many vocal leaders coming back. But, you know, maybe by example.
Well, T. Rob, the defensive plan, the execution against Oklahoma, probably as good as it gets.
Yeah, it was. It turned out to be a real good plan, and you know, I think, you know, we thank Coach Clay and his staff, you know, for giving us that plan to go out and perform to the best of our ability. And the thing about the plan is, I mean, we all went out and had confidence in the plan and went out and played our style of football.
This defense really has shown signs of doing this in spurts throughout the year, but you finally did it for four quarters.
Yeah, and that's the most important thing that the coaches have been instilling into us throughout the season is, you know, we have to play throughout, you know, four quarters, not 30 minutes, not 25 minutes, but, you know, every bit of 60 minutes, and it's very important for each team to go out and play 60 minutes in order to be a good team.
You and I have talked about this a lot over the year. Next season, you'll move in a level spot, and with that, the responsibility of a leader is also there.
Being a leader, yes, it's a tough job. It really is, and especially when you're following in the footsteps of Dwayne Levels, who was a great player here, and you know, we all know that. And the thing about it is, you know, we just got to go out and prepare ourselves all season and lift and be mentally focused coming into this next season and just have fun.
You've been rock solid all year, actually since you've been here. I can't wait to see you in your new role. Thanks a lot.
Thanks, Tom.
Luke, this turned out to be a storybook season for you, but I suspect you had the confidence that you could get this job done if given the chance.
Of course, I have to have the confidence. Being a kicker, you have to have the confidence to go in and be able to hit that game winner. And that's something that we've always done is, you know, it's, we're out there practicing and it's, 54-yard field goal to beat OU, final seconds, you know, and we kind of challenge ourselves that way. So it's a lot of mental, and you have to have the confidence to do it.
15-17 in field goals this year, but you saved the best for last, not once, but twice, 52-yarders.
All I can say about that is it's God willing. The opportunity was there, and I just performed, you know, like I was supposed to. I just went out and did my job. I couldn't ask for a better hold than Scott Elder. He has been amazing. He has taught me so much and brought me up. And Scott is just the amazing, the offensive line, Matt Henson, Jed Newkirk, snappers. Just, you know, you've got to credit them because it's not just me. Knowing that I had that type of season, I know that people are going to expect it now. And, you know, missing the two and being 15-17, that means, you know, that I do have room for improvement. So that's something that I'm going to, you know, have to perfect and try to be perfect in what I do.
Being from Tulsa, you have the bragging rights for at least one more year.
Definitely. I've gotten a lot of calls from a lot of my OU friends, and being from Oklahoma, I know a lot of people at OU. And, you know, they're a little upset with me, but, you know, they're happy for me. And it's kind of I can get to go home Christmas break and kind of just, I don't have to say anything because they know.
Rashaun Woods, I believe his heart was racing. I don't believe he was nervous for a minute. I think he expected himself to make that play, and his leadership was enjoyed this year. It'll be looked to more significantly next year. Terrence Robinson talked about a plan that was devised by the defensive staff. They did a great job, but the key, and he said it, is they executed it to the best of their ability. And Terrence has played like that for us all year long. Luke Phillips, competitive, very confident, 52-yarders in the biggest game versus our in-state rival. He's just everything we've ever wanted at that position. And the understanding that those three young men that were highlighted will be back next year to provide leadership and to relive the trials and the successes of this last season.
Coming up, the coach and I talk recruiting when the Les Miles Show continues after this. Well, the Cowboys win over Oklahoma was a big one. It was certainly an enjoyable win for Cowboy fans across the country. But what made it even better is the fact that a national television audience watched the game. With all that exposure to your big win over Oklahoma, that's really got to help your recruiting, huh?
Make no mistake about it. It was watched throughout the country in the area that we're recruiting. In the homes that we've been in, they shared the story of the game and all had comments. They saw the fans in orange. They saw support in an away stadium. It proves that we can win and that we can win against the best.
How's it translate into commitments?
Well, we have a number of commitments at this point. On-campus visitations start this weekend. We will have a very talented class, and the future is very bright with the Cowboys.
Well, coming up, another look at the big win, a musical tribute to the Cowboys' victory over Oklahoma. That's coming up on our Southwestern Bell 2-Minute Drill next. Well, what a day it was. The Cowboys wrap up the season with a huge win at Oklahoma. Here's a final musical look at the victory on our Southwestern Bell 2-Minute Drill.
And they can celebrate in Stillwater. What an upset. A shock in Norman this afternoon. The bath for Les Miles.
And that feels good.
Fraternity team finished first in the nation.
Yeah.
Davis Bryant, going to make a miss. Got away for the first one. And gets a wall over to the sideline. But a great job of bringing it back by Terrence Davis Bryant.
Our defense took it to their offense.
Blitz from the outside. Hybl doesn't see it.
Some quarterbacks made plays. Sean made plays.
Fields, fade, corner. Rashaun Woods, jump ball, touchdown, Oklahoma State!
You know, to go out, especially on top of OU, being my last one in OSU Cowboy uniform, kind of emotional or whatever, but it was a big win. Would have no other way but to go out and start. God put together a full game, you know, and we did that today.
With all the leadership that we had out of the senior group, we all came together as a family and came out with a victory today. Oh yeah, we want to punish them. Make sure, you know, make sure that this last game, you know, that they remember that, you know, we're still Oklahoma State. Perfect way to go out.
Kevin Williams and the Waylon Brown to me, and Greg Richmond, Kareem Smith, are four of the most upfront talented guys, I guess, in the country. I mean, they're quick, strong, and they read the play well, and today they played their heart out, you know, and I'm just happy to be a Cowboy right now.
Hybl keeps it, surrounded in the backfield, and knocked down at the 16-yard line. Terrence Robinson knocked him down.
It was a great opportunity for me, and Scott Elder held the ball perfect. Matt Henson snapped the ball perfect. The offensive line blocked perfect, and, you know, and God willing, it went in.
I just kind of laid the ball up, and TD did the rest of the work on his pass, and Rashaun did the rest of the work on that touchdown. So as far as I'm concerned, you know, they did all of it today.
So Josh Field just throw it up and give me a chance to make a play on the ball.
And what I did, went up and took it from Roy Williams.
It's kind of one of the things you dream about, you know, ended it at the end of a game with a score. So he played it pretty good, but Rashaun just went up and had an incredible catch there. So
Fields under center, the true freshman, barking out the signals, drops back the pass, pumps, throws it toward the far corner of the end zone, and the pass is caught! Touchdown, Cowboys! Rolling out to the near side, has time. Now here comes the pressure, throws it deep down the near sideline, and the pass is...
intercepted, perhaps?
Intercepted? Yes. Intercepted by the Cowboys!
That'll do it!
Marcus Jones with the interception, and let the party begin, folks!
Save big at your Oklahoma Ford dealer. Get 0 points.
I want to thank our fans and supporters, those people that have been with us all year. Special thanks to those people that came to Gallagher Iber Arena after we returned from Norman to give us the opportunity to sing the alma mater one more time. We'll take this momentum into the offseason and look forward to next year.
Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next fall.
The Les Miles Show.